At the young age of 21, Katlyn was thrilled when her boyfriend surprised her with a marriage proposal.
Kevin and I met back in high school, our sophomore year.
When I first saw Katlyn, her beautiful eyes were the most attractive eyes I've ever seen in my life.
His personality is what attracted me. It's a lot of fun to be around.
I can always talk to her about anything. She's the love of my life.
I had my whole plan worked out of how I was gonna do everything in life.
It's perfect.
I wanted to finish school first and get married and then have kids. My plan was dead set. I had all my ducks in a row. There was not gonna be a kink in my chains.
The couple decided not to get married for at least 4 years to give Katlyn time to complete her dental hygienist degree. She was scheduled to start university that autumn.
I wanted to just enjoy my summer before school started. We went to bars, had a big time with friends. I didn't have a care in the world.
As the couple were not ready to have children, Katlyn used a contraceptive pill.
I was taking birth control every day. My periods were normal and they would last 3 days, and one day would be really heavy and the rest would be just light.
In September, Katlyn started her degree and also began a new diet and exercise regime.
I started really getting on a big streak about working out and eating healthier. I was going walking every day and I started losing weight. And I saw the pounds start dropping and they seemed to drop off real quick because I was down 30 pounds.
In September, Katlyn decided to go visit her family. She wanted to go show everybody how much she had lost and tell everybody how great she felt.
We was very supportive of her losing the weight and we encouraged her. When she gets her mind set on something and wants to do it, she does it.
She continued working out on a regular basis. But in October, she was sick several times while exercising.
Katlyn started experiencing some nausea and vomiting.
Katlyn thought the reason she was getting sick was because of her allergies. The congestion made her sick.
I took some different types of allergy medicine. I didn't think anything else about it. I'm starting to freak out a little bit because my pain started getting worse. These cramps were so bad, I felt like somebody was still punching me. I was sitting on the toilet and all of a sudden I get this awful, sharp pain. It made me double over and I fell straight down to my knees. It felt like somebody had just come up with a baseball bat and just hit me in the stomach so hard. In a scale of 1 to 10, the pain is like a 12. I wanted to see what was going on. And I feel down there, and I felt a baby's head. I was terrified. I didn't know whether to scream, what to do. Something came over my body. I had to push. It was just a feeling of, I had to do this. I'm on the ground, I'm pushing. I feel like somebody is still beating me with a bat. It was the worst pain I've ever felt before. I pushed twice. Relief comes over my body. There is no more pain. But then I look down and I see the baby's face. And I'm in shock. How did I just have a baby? I had all my periods, was on birth control. I had lost 30 pounds. How could I be pregnant? I was very scared. The baby was laying there just very, very still. There was no movement, no nothing. I thought he was dead. I thought he was a stillborn. And I was like, it's my fault. All this is my fault. I should have known I was pregnant.
Kevin!
I yelled for Kevin to come in there.
I ran in there when all I could see was Katlyn on her knees on the floor and I see a lot of blood and I look down and I see her holding our little baby.
He was in complete and utter shock.
I had to take a second to realize what was going on. I mean, am I dreaming? I was scared to death. I didn't know what to do. I just wanted to make sure she was okay and the baby was okay.
the baby started crying. I was very relieved, but still terrified. He's not moving.
What do we do? I don't know.
If a baby isn't breathing or moving for a sustained period of time, it may mean that didn't get enough oxygen in the uterus and may signal a bigger problem, like brain damage.
All I can think about this moment is I just want them to be okay. I want to get help there as fast as I can. I call 911 as fast as I can find the phone.
Hey, my fiance just had a baby in the bathroom.
Somebody was pregnant, was she?
We didn't even know she was.
She said she didn't know she was pregnant?
No, ma'am.
And the baby is completely out?
Yes, and it's crying.
I don't know what to do. I'm just sitting there, holding the baby.
You wiped the baby's mouth off?
Did you wipe the baby's mouth off?
Wipe the baby's mouth and nose, and draw the baby with a clean towel.
Clean towel?
Wrap the baby in a clean, dry towel, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
And cover the baby's head, but not its face.
Okay.
I'm freaking out, but I know I have to stay calm to keep Katlyn calm. Because if I freak out, Katlyn's going to freak out. So it's real hard to stay calm in that situation.
Okay, now we're going to tie the cord.
What?
Can you find a string or a shoelace?
Yes.
So I ran in there and found the first shoelace I could find.
Okay.
I want you to tie that string about 6 inches from the baby. Don't cut it.
Okay.
I'm shaking. I'm scared. I think it's a nightmare. I think I'm in an awful dream. I'm still in shock.
Keep the baby warm and keep your girlfriend warm, okay?
Okay. Are you warm, baby?
Is she warm?
Yes.
It felt like it took hours for him to get there, which it only took 7 minutes, but those 7 minutes were awful.
Okay. They're in here.
When we got there, it was still pretty tense. The first thing we saw was a newborn child. The bathroom floor had a large amount of blood. We knew this was serious.
When we get up to the hospital, they get rush us right into a room, and there's doctors waiting on the baby, and there's doctors waiting on me.
Where are they taking him?
Katlyn was starting to realize she had just delivered and was, I think, more scared than anything.
They just took him to the nursery. They're going to make sure he's okay.
Doctors quickly determined that Katlyn's bleeding was not serious and she wasn't in danger of hemorrhaging.
They told me that Katlyn was fine, but I was pacing around waiting to hear something about the baby.
The baby underwent a number of tests to make sure his heart and lungs were functioning properly. The doctors hoped Katlyn's lack of antenatal care had not harmed him.
My worst fear is something's wrong with the baby. Because I did so much partying and drinking. It made me feel horrible. The worst person in the world.
An hour passed, and the couple hadn't heard any news about their baby's condition.
Well, I was really starting to wonder, what if something bad happened? What if they had to rush him into surgery or something like that? What if he had to be shipped into intensive care?
I wanted the baby to be okay. And I didn't know if he was going to be or not.
I was waiting, I want to say like 2 hours. That was hard for me.
Is he okay?
The doctors checked the baby out and said that he was perfectly healthy. He didn't have any complications.
The baby weighed 8 pounds, 9 ounces. I was estimated to be from 42 to 43 weeks pregnant. It was just a sigh of relief. He was the most beautiful baby I've ever seen, and I was just so excited in knowing that he was okay and he was healthy. It was just amazing.
I'm glad that everything's okay, because anything could happen. I pretty much started crying when I first held him. I just knew that my life had changed forever, and he was my new world. He was the sweetest thing I've ever seen in my life. I was so happy. I was just smiling from ear to ear.